do it again and improve somebody else. She says it's like a genius for bringing up children. The woman who have that, she says, keep schools. They are so good at it that they have to be unfaithful to their own children and run after other people's, she says, and in just the same way she maintains a woman with a genius for improving men by love ought to improve them by the dozen. What do you think of that? There's something in that, you know. What? I mean, of course, logically, it's improper, but it makes good sense. I wonder what's the proper answer to it. That's what she says. Oh, and what do you say to her? I tell her that the proper answer to it is that she ought to be ashamed of herself. Does that do any good? No. Has she ceased to care for you? No. She says she will practice on me to keep her hand in, but that she is getting tired of me and must have say to your paragon, my paragon, have I said a word in her defense? Have you said a word in mine? But don't you see what the consequences will be if you separate? You will lose all control over her, and then there will be a divorce. I haven't any control over her at present. The junior clerk enters. A lady to see you, sir. She is a very beautiful lady. Oh, sir, if she is in any trouble, will you help her? If she is accused, do not believe a word against her. I'll stake my life on her innocence. Well, really, Mr. Guppy, what name? I forgot to ascertain her name, sir.